Hello dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Avneet Kaur, Assistant Professor in Education, Ranjit Avenue, Amritsar. Today we will discuss about the topic Trends of Research in Educational Administration, Gaps and Priorities. The objectives of this topic are to understand the need of the research in educational administration, identify the various areas of research in educational administration, discuss the recent trends of research in educational administration, acquaint with the latest information about the developments in the area of educational administration research, identify various gaps in the educational administration research, and know about various priorities in the field of research in educational administration. Now, first of all, we will discuss the need of research in educational administration. The major need of research in educational administration is firstly to improve administrative patterns and practices to bring efficiency in school organization and classroom management for the betterment of educational standards by improving instructions. Secondly, to enable educationists and educational administrators to plan improved developmental programs, and thirdly, to modify the administrative patterns and organizational structures in accordance with the changing and over-expenditure process in which new developments take place according to the changing needs of the nation. Next, we will learn about the different areas of research in educational administration. These are, first, investigation needed on the administrator. It includes analysis of the behavior of administrator and its impact on educational administration, studies in values and attitudes of educational administration, case studies of educational administrators such as directors, inspectors, headmasters, etc., and studies in morals of educational administration. The second area is the research needed on the administration. It includes studies like investigations in school-community relationships and studies in the role of educational administration in the process of social change in India. The third area includes studies in the administrative problems of education. It comprises studies like an investigation into the functioning of central school system, analysis of administrative services in a state, and investigation into the problem of incentive, motivation in professional growth, and so on. The fourth area is research in comparative educational administration. It includes comparison of central administrative machinery of education in India with any of the developed and underdeveloped countries, and comparative study of interstate educational administrative patterns. Fifth is the research in administration of different stages of education, which includes an investigation into the management of elementary education in a district or city, a critical study into institutional planning, and a critical study of different models of educational planning. Sixth area is research in educational finance, which includes an inquiry into tapping of private sources of educational finance and an investigation into financing of education as human resource development. Seventh area is research in educational research, which includes administration of educational research at the national level, an investigation into the role of state institutes of education in research, and an inquiry into the role of the NCERT in promoting educational administration research. Eighth area is research and reforms in educational administration, which includes a critical analysis of educational administrative reforms carried out at the center or state level, and a comparative study of educational administrative reforms effective in two states. Ninth area is the investigation needed in the process of administration listed as under. Studies in the administrative process suited to educational system, analysis of the decision-making process in educational administration at various levels and behavioral agencies such as school, colleges, universities, etc., and studies into the adoption of centralization or decentralization on educational administration. Now we will discuss about the trends of research in educational administration in India. The existing educational administration in India is essentially concerned with controlling. It is generally slow and hesitant, dilatory and time consuming. Unless the educational system is well equipped with appropriately trained modern managers who in turn are well equipped with modern tools of analysis, research and evaluation, and at the same time with the latest information about the developments in the area of educational administration and research, it cannot function effectively and efficiently. All approaches to organization study and studies in the area of educational administration aim at maximum efficiency in the task for which the educational system is set up. Educational administration as a subject of study and research has not received much attraction all over the world, though it was introduced in teacher education programs at B.Ed. and M.Ed. levels as a subject of study. The popular belief is that educational administration needs no special training, and it is in the school of experience that educational administrators learn techniques and procedures of administration. Barring one or two universities, nowhere in India a separate department exists for educational administration. Administration of education, like any other field of administration, is oriented to human experiences and has concern about effective management, quality output, and greater and faster development in the area that is administered. Earlier, the emphasis in educational administration was laid upon direction and control, discipline and penal acts, strict and detached personal administration, and production emphasis. The outputs were conceived in a greater quantum, irrespective of the size and nature of the inputs. The system of educational administration was colored with bureaucratism and saturated with the cult of authority and domination. The product was valued more than the process and the producers, and there was little concern for consumers too. The research in educational administration at doctoral level had its beginning in the early years of 19th century. The dominant trend in these researches was description and evaluation of the role of educational structure and authorities and agencies at different stages of education, with focus on the emergent problems. The focal points were structure, officials, rules and regulations, inspection, control and finance, and the guiding philosophy stressed the operational aspect of the administration of education. The two of manifested dimensions of research in educational administration that cut right through the 1960s were historical and comparative. None of these studies reflected a concern for evolving some base for seeking support in the theory of educational administration. Even today, researchers in educational administration hardly recognize the role of theory of educational administration, and they seldom use any model of administrative theory as the frame of reference. In India, a small beginning in research in educational administration began in the 1940s with the research by R.V. Parulekar and J.P. Naik on primary education. A trend became visible in the 1950s for more collaborative research in educational administration among professors and advanced graduate students, though on a small scale. The change noticeable in some of the doctoral researches that were completed in the late 1960s or early 70s is comparatively more reliant on human relations approach, the administration and the supervisors' jobs began to be viewed and evaluated in terms of not only their leadership acts, hierarchical organizational structure, authorities-oriented production emphasis, maintenance of discipline and order through strict observation of rule and regulations, interference, hindrance and intimation, but in terms of effective personal management, satisfaction of staff's social needs and psychological needs, and considerate use of the skill of human engineering on the part of the administrators. In the matter of approach and treatment of data, welcome departures are noticeable. The treatment now tends to be more analytical and interpretive in place of the large-scale use of description and aggregate compilation approach prevalent in the 50s and early 60s. Sophisticated statistics also sometimes finds place in the doctoral studies, but this trend is still feeble. Field investigations and case study methods have also been used at some places, though in part measures. In the areas like center-state relationship, educational planning and financing, the use of aggregate analysis, methods are mainly based on field studies. Case studies, critical and interpreted studies of published and unpublished documents, authoritative reports, proceeding and decision-making process and results have also emerged. A recent trend that has emerged in research in educational administration, though still it is in embryonic stage, is to study the administration of education as a cumulative effect of evaluation of the process of administration involving facets such as planning, organizing, directing, coordinating, communicating, human relations and evacuation. Another concern that has been reflected in some doctoral researches and research projects is to draw with discrimination upon insights into administration derived from other fields and disciplines. Next, we will discuss about the overall trends of research in educational administration. The following observations were made from the studies reviewed from this survey. First, there is a good deal of empirical research that has been done in the last few years on organization, administration, and management of education. Second, the empirical researchers have attempted to study a variety of issues, including institutional climate, effectiveness of leadership, administrative problems, teacher satisfaction, student attitudes and achievement, etc. A variety of educational organizations have been studied, including secondary schools, colleges, private and government, research institutions, universities, ordinary and agricultural, open university systems, as well as the district level administration. There seems to be an increasing trend of studying colleges and universities, although the total number of studies conducted are insignificant. Fourth, the sampling procedures used in almost all the studies appear to be good. The generalizations are based on well acceptable sample sizes, some of which are randomly drawn and others are drawn purposively. The most frequently used instruments in these studies include Organizational Climate Description Questionnaire, OCDQ, of Halpin and Croft, or Leadership Behavior Description Questionnaires of M.L. Sharma. The researchers in a few cases have developed their own questionnaires. Researchers also seem to use interviews, observations, and analysis of records. A large number of researchers have used more than one method. Seventh, in quite a few cases, the findings of the researchers provide significant insights for a local level administration at school, college, or district level. Now we will discuss about the priorities in the field of research in educational administration. Even a cursory look at the number of studies conducted revealed that the area has attracted the attention of a very large number of researchers in India. However, This should not be taken to imply that the area has been explored exhaustively. On the contrary, many of the studies are just peripheral to the main concern of educational management. Thus, the researchers have to set clear priorities in order to make future studies more meaningful and relevant. We will now have a look at the neglected areas. Some of the neglected areas of research in educational administration are, first, administrative climate of educational institutions, second, administrative behaviors of principals, third, human relations, fourth, communication, fifth, evaluation as a feedback device, sixth, institutional and decentralized educational planning, seventh, the evaluation of the planning machinery in education, eighth, training of educational administrators in managerial skills and procedures of planning, university governance, and operational effectiveness of its authorities, boards, and committees, and decision making in universities. Ninth, educational administration as a social science discipline. Let's now discuss what has been ignored in the researches so far. The researchers have not touched themes that are critical for improving the quality of education, including its managerial efficiency. While most of the studies are of academic interest, they have limited value in bringing about changes in the organizational administration and management of education. There is a need to focus these studies on each category of institutions. There are too few in each category to be generalized. Primary education is completely neglected by researchers in this area. The researchers seem to take too many variables at a time for their study. Quite a few studies present innumerable findings. Consequently, one gets lost in them. It is useful to limit future researchers to a few variables and study them exhaustively. Action research is noticeably absent in the present scenario. Management is one field where there could be a lot of experimentation. Change-oriented studies should be encouraged in future. Now we will discuss about some problem areas formulated on the basis of the goals of science for the sake of illustration. They can be further elaborated and specified by the researchers themselves as, first, identifying goals of educational administration in India or with reference to any other country. Second, identifying tasks of educational administration in a given social system. Third, identifying processes of educational administration, analyzing concepts like educational administration, inspection, supervision, school management, administrative behavior, leadership, and so on. Fifth, classifying types of organizations or functions and characteristics of administrative processes. Sixth, describing systematically the qualities or traits of effective administrator or successful leader or ideal inspector or popular headmaster, and so on. Seventh, testing ability and aptitude in persons for the job of educational administrators or leader. Eighth, building personality skills for school administrators. Ninth, constructing measures for workload of school administrators for their effective performance, for their leadership role, for impact of supervision and inspection on schools, and the like. Tenth, hypothetical studies and correlations of different variables involved in the administrative behavior in education. To summarize, this module discusses about the trends of research in educational administration, their gaps, and their priorities. Broadly, the areas which need research may include decision making, communication, leadership behavior, organizational behavior, conflict resolution, group dynamics, system analysis and network analysis, educational planning and training of personnel. With regard to this research finding in these areas, it may safely be assumed that they may lead to maximum utilization of available human and material resources. At the same time, researchers in these areas may provide empirical grounds for planning and executing training programs for educating the managers of educational enterprise, which is the need of the day. Thank you so much.